Out of nowhere, here comes some punk. He wants your wallet and your cell phone and your bag of Whataburgers. No! You hand him the money and the phone, but hold on to your burgers like your life depends on it. That was a close call, but you made it, at least this time. If you had paid attention to YouTube every now and then, you would have known never to have gone to that neighborhood, because that part of Texas is bad news, fella. Texas isn't the most dangerous state overall, but it's up there. According to the latest numbers put out by the FBI, it's the 12th most dangerous state of all when you take into account the number of robberies, assaults, shootings, murders, and other crimes per capita. There's a lot of places in Texas where you could chill out and never be bothered, but in many parts of this state, you gotta watch your back. And apparently, your bag of Whataburgers. Now, in order to determine how dangerous a particular city is, you just need to look at how much crime happens there and what your chances are of being a victim of said crime. Some of the cities we'll talk about are small, but they are packing heat. And some of the bigger cities in Texas are going to be dangerous, that's for sure. I'll tell you that. Now, around here, I'm the sheriff. And when you call the law, you call me. So let's lock them up. We're going to take a look at the most dangerous cities in Texas, hombre. If you want to be alone in Texas, you can be alone. Everybody here will tell you better hide from all of the dangerous. Texas, one of our fastest growing states of all. High crime in many areas certainly isn't enough to deter people from flocking here in droves. Going back 10 years ago, Texas was 21st in the nation for murders. Today, it's exactly average, ranking 25th for murders per capita. So it's less murderous here these days, although property crimes and assaults have definitely gone up in this state, especially in places like Amarillo. Crime has certainly gotten much worse here over the last few years, I'll tell you that, pal. Amarillo is a medium-sized city way up in the Texas panhandle. It's the biggest city in this whole region. The population here reached about 200,000 people, but as you can see, it's plateaued. Maybe that's because of the crime. I mean, overall, it's about an average place, sort of poor and rundown, but not too bad. Here in Amarillo, you'd have about a 1 in 138 chance of being the victim of an assault, rape, or murder for each year that you lived here. And last year, there were more than 7,800 robberies in Amarillo, which is about 21 a day. Police in Amarillo seem to be frustrated, and you can understand why. I mean, it seems like these losers are never going to stop with the bullshit. There's been an increase in the number of violent crimes here, including more shootings over the last couple years. By September of this year, Amarillo's already had 194 armed robberies, which is way higher than normal. In an average year, there's 15 murders here. This year, there's already been 21 murders, and we still have 4 more months to go. People say there's just more guns on the streets in Amarillo these days. People are leaving guns out in plain view in their cars, and they're getting broken into. One officer said, "We're trying hard. We're brainstorming. We're working with a bunch of different agencies to see what we can do." When there's so many guns out there and there's that many people willing to do stuff like this, it's just hard to stop them unless you're in the same spot at the same time. This isn't the last time we're going to be in this part of the state. Now, Beaumont, Texas has never been a safe place. Currently, it's the 9th most dangerous place in Texas, but ask people in certain parts of Beaumont about that and they'll tell you it seems like this city's first. Beaumont's population is about 115,000 and it peaked years ago, like 60 years ago. It's not really a very desirable place to be, but there's some good hardworking folks down here near the Louisiana state line. If you lived in Beaumont for a year, you would have about a 1 in 95 chance of being attacked, raped, or killed. Your odds would probably be better avoiding a gator attack down here than an assault. Just yesterday, this dude Ricky Johnson shot and killed some other guy and his woman in the parking lot of a hookah lounge because they had beef with each other. Stuff like that happens all the time here in Beaumont, I'll tell you that. The madness gotta stop, one community member said about the violence here in Beaumont. I won't move back to Beaumont. It's too much going on, said somebody else. A third person said, it's getting bad. You need to be on guard out here. I read about all this stuff happening on the news, but when it happened at your house, it like, woo, this is real. Of course, crime in Beaumont's nothing like it was back in the early 90s. But after a low in 2010, violent crime's back up here again by more than 20%. What the hell are they going to do in Beaumont to fix this mess? Now you tell somebody in Texas you're from the O, and they're like, oh no, this place is off the chain for robberies and shootings. It's right along I-20. There's a lot of crime just because of that. And look how the crime's gone up in Odessa over time. Back in 2004, Odessa was just about tied for the U.S. average with crime. Then in 2012, look what happened. Today, Odessa is nearly three times more dangerous than the average U.S. city. What happened 10 years ago to make crime go up by so much here? Now, we haven't mentioned any border towns yet, and we won't. That might be a surprise to you. The border town that ranks the highest for crime is Donna, way down in the Rio Grande Valley. Sure, Donna, McAllen, and Mission, they're all real dumps. But most of the crimes that happen in smallish Texas border towns like these are petty crimes, like robberies. If you're a criminal, you want to do all your bad deeds more inland, away from all the law enforcement, right? If I was the sheriff in that county, I would throw those criminals over the wall and let them live with the Mexicans. Super gay cop, you prove that there are some hardcore conservative gays in America.
I'm going to the big D and I mean danger.
Everybody knows Dallas is a really dangerous place in some parts. Northwest Dallas, South Dallas, South Boulevard Park Row. I mean, look at this map. Dark blue is really dangerous, and it looks like just about the whole south end of town's one big crime zone. You definitely want to live on the north end if you make Dallas your home one day. Overall, for every man, woman, and child here, there's a 1 in 23 chance of being robbed, beaten up, or killed. Of course, 4 in 5 crimes here are robberies, so that's a bit of posturing. And if you stayed off the streets at night and didn't hang out with ghetto people, you'd probably be okay. But check this out. Dallas crime's been going down by quite a lot since the peak in the early 90s when everybody had a gun and a cowboy beanie. Assaults are up in Dallas by 6%, but violence here is down 6%, and robberies are down 25% since last year. What the hell are they doing there? Well, new police chief Eddie Garcia's plan seems to be working. More cops in high crime areas. It's really not that difficult. They're focusing on targeting drug houses and treating poverty as a root of violent crime. Dallas PD's plan is to change the pattern of the high-risk re-offender. First off, they're just really aggressive in arresting the criminals. Then when it comes to less hardened criminals, the city's encouraging them to be involved in the community and find other things to do besides get into trouble. Imagine that. See? And you said defunding the police was a good idea. They're increasing the police presence, and look what happened. Now, San Antonio's crime's been shooting up lately, literally. There were 11,000 violent crimes here last year, and somebody had their shit stolen 50,000 times. That's like every 10 minutes in San Antonio, somebody gets robbed. Plus, more than 20 cars are stolen in San Antonio every single day. Drugs and gangs, I'll tell ya. San Antonio had 81 murders in the first half of last year so far, and it's on track for one of the deadliest years in nearly three decades. And that doesn't even count justifiable homicides, like when somebody kills somebody in self-defense. Now, I thought Texas was tough on crime, but maybe they're just overwhelmed with too many cases. Check out this example. There's this guy, Eduardo Mendez Amezquita. He went nuts and kept his family hostage and made a big scene after shooting at the police. Well, they wound up killing him, but this guy had been arrested 7 times in 10 years for DUIs and assaults and other mischief. He barely served any time. They just kept letting him out. And look what happened. Back in 1993, they called San Antonio the drive-by shooting capital of the nation because there were 220 murders here. Then violent crime went down, but then in 2016, it started to go back up again. San Antonio's newest plan is to go after the worst perps, rather than just focus on certain hotspots in town. Hopefully that works, because shit's off the chain here right now. Cleveland's always been a rough and tumble place here in Texas. It's about 45 minutes outside of Houston along Route 59. It's statistically more dangerous in Cleveland than in San Antonio when you measure crimes on a per capita basis. For every year you spend in Cleveland, you have a 1 in 15 chance of being some sort of victim. That's about somebody in every third house on every block. Now, there's only about 8,000 people here, so you're not going to see huge numbers of murders in Cleveland. But for such a small place, crime is really bad. Only 2% of all U.S. cities are more dangerous than little Cleveland, Texas. He freaking ha. Now, we're going to go back out west for number 4, Lubbock. There's a 250,000 people here in this college town along I-27. While the sheer number of murders here is going to be far lower than in the big cities, your chances of being the victim here are way up. There's a murder here every month and 32 robberies every single day. What the hell, Lubbock? One recent report from a website you've never heard of claims Lubbock is the third most dangerous city of all major U.S. metro areas, just behind Anchorage and Memphis. Now, I'm sure there's people in Lubbock that are like, there's no way that's true. But look at the rest of the cities on this list. They all make sense to me. Damn, Lubbock, you've got some cleaning up to do. Just outside of Waco, which is also a really bad place for crime, is little teeny tiny Bellmead, population not even 10,000. Now, people in Bellmead can't seem to keep their hands to themselves because this place has the second highest rate of robberies per capita in the whole state. And it's a big state. It's also the 11th most violent place in the state, too. If you lived in Bellmead, you have a 1 in 16 chance of being robbed every year. What the hell? Now, in an effort to be more involved in the community, Bellmead police officers are handing out candy and toys to all the kids. Now, hopefully those kids that were so grateful for getting those toys wind up remembering that when they're thinking about doing something bad later in life. Now, where's our second most dangerous place to live in Texas by statistics? Humble is. There's about 15,000 people here north of Houston. Technically, this is the worst place in the whole state for robberies per capita. In Humble, you'd have a 1 in 9 chance of being robbed every single year. 1 in 9, everyone. Humble also has the third highest frequency of rape cases in Texas and has the highest murder rate of anywhere else in Texas, too. Crime is 380% higher in Humble than the average dangerous U.S. town. And look at this. Humble is safer than 0% of all other U.S. cities. Poverty and drugs gets them every time, I tell you. Look at all the headlines from just one news site in the last few months. There's something in here from murders to shootings and robberies and beatings. But Humble has nothing on our most dangerous place to live in Texas. Of course, Houston. Now, we could do a whole video on how dangerous Houston is. Actually, I did a whole video on how dangerous Houston is. It's called Houston's Worst Neighborhoods. Basically, that video says you should avoid all of South Houston, especially after dark. If you want to live, that is. Now, crime's always been bad in Houston, and now it's just getting worse. Last year, there were 400 murders here, and that's a 42% increase from last year, and that's the highest since the early 1990s. Beatings are up, shootings are up, welfare fraud is up, illegal gambling is up, sexual assaults are up, weapons violations up, kidnappings are up, and Houston was already one of the biggest hubs for child trafficking in the nation. And get this, as the number of cops on the streets goes down, crime goes up. Who would have thought? Take 100 officers off the streets in Houston and more people die. It was just reported that every half hour in Houston, somebody's beaten up. And get this, in Houston's most crime-ridden neighborhood of Sunnyside, a crime was reported every 7 hours. And it's not a very big neighborhood either. The number of murders in Houston has gone up by more than Chicago and LA. And in New York City last year, there were 462 murders. Houston had 402, and New York is 4 times bigger. What the hell? The Houston Chronicle says this won't be fixed until Houston courts can operate efficiently. There's just a huge backlog in cases and not enough prosecutors and court personnel to handle them. There's 5,500 violent offenders in jail waiting for a trial right now, and tens of thousands more just out on bail, walking around, looking for trouble. Maybe instead of more cops on the streets, we need more judges in the seats. Huh, everyone? Of course, not everywhere in Texas is dangerous. Come on now. There's a lot of places here where folks act like normal human beings. The safest of all Texas communities are going to be in some of the wealthiest places. Imagine that. That's not a surprise. But if you're curious, and I know you are, just about all the safest places you can live in Texas are going to be in the North Dallas burbs or in the Western Houston burbs. So there you go. Go there if you want to keep your families and your Whataburgers safe. The end. If you want to be alone, you can't live here and be alone. Everybody here will tell you better hide from all of the dangerous. Hey guys, so if anything I just talked about upset you or made you sad or mad, well then do something about it. Call your local leaders and demand change. Chip in and help those in need. Make your community better. Because communities don't get better without hard work and determination. America's a great place. It just needs some more love and pride.
This is Sage, Nick's manager. This has been a Corner House Entertainment production.
And are you looking to move and need advice? I do consulting. That's right. I'll sit down and talk about where the next perfect place for you and your family should be. I do it all the time. Together, let's find you a new home that's safe and checks all your boxes. You can get my email in the description to find out how I can help you find your perfect relocation.